Welcome back to another TriPro tutorial. Today we are talking about the streamer mode, or rather overlay mode. What is the overlay mode? Basically, it overlays the TriPro and basically shows you if for the current aircraft that you fly in IL-2 or for in DCS, basically the in-game corresponding button on of what you pressed. So if I press my second station, it will tell like second stage trigger, or if I press any button, it will give the in-game description as you would see it in the menu. How to set it up? You have a new button for that, which is called Settings Overlay. You can click on that and can put in the settings here. Quickly explained. Window height should be self-explanatory, window width should be self-explanatory, like which color the text should have, which text font it should have, which size it should have, how many maximum elements should be displayed, poll time in milliseconds, so every 16 milliseconds it makes like one cycle, so it's basically a 60Hz refresh rate, pretty much. And the last one is only like if you use the text time alive option, which I will do. So text time alive means like once a button is not pressed anymore, basically then it stays for that amount of milliseconds alive and then basically disappears. If text time alive mode is off, then as soon as you don't press the button anymore, it disappears. What is the change button state mode? The change button state mode only basically shows the button whenever it switches stage, so like from not pressed to pressed and pressed to not pressed. And so if you would use this mode without the text time alive, it would only just pop up very, very shortly, and you wouldn't really see it very well. So it's highly advised to use this mode with the text time alive, or just use the change basically both off. That's kind of my advice here. In order to make it work, you need to click on the install script button. That will install the according stuff into your export lua file, so my tool can talk with DCS in terms of what airplane you sit in. If you click on it, it tells you if it was installed, and for me it says it, as I have it already installed, that I already had it installed. Then I close it, and then once I'm happy with everything, I just double check that everything is here. Yeah, text time alive is on. I click on overlay, and that will open the overlay. Right now I won't see much because I don't have any buttons pressed, rather. And so one thing I will do right now, as I already had the script installed, I'm already in DCS. Important is that you open this overlay once you're in the main menu and not in the game. You need to be in the main menu because like DCS connects you as soon as you load into a mission with the program. So, and if you just install the script, please restart DCS entirely. So, let's just quickly jump in into a quick mission and demonstrate what it does. Yeah, let's just go for the Hornet and free flight. Now if I press a button, for instance, for stage 2, you see it on the top corner, that's been pressed. I can, if it, the position annoys me, it can go with the mouse here and move it around, or like go here and press it like that. If I want to press, once I press scrim, it will show up and highlight it. It's pretty good, as if you want to make video tutorials to show like what you have pressed and what you have. Alright, this concludes this tutorial, and have a nice day.